Captain Jim came along another evening to bring Anne some mayflowers. The garden was full of the moist, scented air of a maritime spring evening. There was a milk-white mist on the edge of the sea, with the young moon kissing it, and a silver gladness of stars over the glen. The bell of the church across the harbor was ringing dreamily sweet. The mellow chime drifted through the dusk to mingle with the soft spring moan of the sea. Captain Jim's mayflowers added the last completing touch to the charm of the night. "I haven't seen any this spring, and I've missed them," said Anne, burying her face in them. "They ain't to be found around Four Winds, only in the barrens away behind the glen up yonder. I took a little trip today to the land of nothing to do, and hunted these up for you. I reckon they're the last you'll see this spring, for they're nearly done." "How kind and thoughtful you are, Captain Jim. Nobody else, not even Gilbert," with a shake of her head at him, "remembered that I always long for mayflowers in the spring." "Well, I had another errand, too. I wanted to take Mr. Howard back yonder a mess of trout. He likes one occasional, and it's all I can do for a kindness he did me once. I stayed all the afternoon and talked to him. He likes to talk to me, though he's a highly educated man, and I'm only an ignorant old sailor, because he's one of the folks that's got to talk, or they're miserable, and he finds listeners scarce round here. The Glen folks might shy of him because they think he's an infidel. He ain't that far gone exactly. Few men is, I reckon. But he's what you might call a heretic. Heretics are wicked, but they're mighty interesting. It's just that they've got sort of lost looking for God, being under the impression that he's hard to find, which he ain't never. Most of 'em blunder to him after a while, I guess. I don't think listening to Mr. Howard's arguments is likely to do me much harm. Mind you, I believe what I was brought up to believe. It saves a vast bother. And back of it all, God is good. The trouble with Mr. Howard is that he's a little too clever. He thinks that he's bound to live up to his cleverness, and that it's smarter to thrash out some new way of getting to heaven than to go by the old track the common ignorant folks is traveling. But he'll get there sometime, all right, and then he'll laugh at himself.